Good morning, Dana. Thank you
Good
for being here.
morning.
Good morning. I was a journaler growing up, so I really
Wow.
understood the power of journaling and getting all those emotions and feelings out. But what I really loved when I really thought about it after the fact was that African Americans, we don't have a lot of family heirlooms, and you created a family heirloom with that journal. I
Oh.
wanted to know what was your instincts in the movie, because I could tell you had a gut feeling that you needed to do something to connect your son with his dad, Charles. So what were your instincts and that pulled you to saying, please do this journal?
Oh my gosh. Well, thank you for asking that. Before I answered, I want to say one thing based on a theme that I'm hearing here. I think just because folks cry doesn't mean that it's a sad movie. It isn't. There are parts of it that are, of course, there are parts of it are sad. You can't love as deeply as we did and not be utterly devastated to lose it, of course. But it's funny. It's uplifting, I hope. And the story overall is a testament to love and the enduring power of love. Love never dies. Love doesn't end. And so in that sense, I think it's an important movie for people to see with family. Excuse me. I think the holiday is a perfect time to see a movie like this with the people you love when we're all reflecting on, what we're grateful for. And we've been isolated during COVID, so hug somebody, take them along with you. But in terms of this heirloom and what made me give it to him and what I was thinking, what is now an heirloom, and thank you, I think of it that way as well. I didn't really have to say, would you please do this? He took to it immediately.
Oh, good.
And I was in a store, actually. I was pregnant, 5 and a half months pregnant, and I was buying a gift for a friend in a gift store. And I saw this and I thought, you know what? What if something happens to him over there? Like, I will at least want our child to see the words, I love you, on a page written from him. If that may be all he ever has of him. And Charles became obsessed with it. He wouldn't put it down.
Yeah, he was very fortunate to have that journal. It's kind of a reinforcement of all that he represents. So it was
That's
beautiful.
exactly right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
How your paths intersected with Denzel Washington and Michael B. Jordan. How did that all come about?
so I first wrote about this in the New York Times, where I was a journalist, because as I said, I knew I was the only national reporter who had had this sort of a military loss and wanted to share it with people. I wrote about it in the Times, and one of my colleagues at the Times, after she read it, sent me an email saying, our readers will demand a book. And that's what happened. And so I set out to do the book. Todd Black, our executive producer, who's Denzel's been Denzel's partner in crime for 30 years, read it and took it to Denzel. And Denzel called me and said, I think I'd be interested in doing this story of your life. And I said, listen, I had my Denzel Washington. His name was Charles. I'm not a Hollywood girl. The only thing I don't want anything from you, except that if you do this movie, please do it well. And I said, and the only other thing I ask is that you meet Jordan, because there is a real Jordan behind this. And Denzel and I have been friends ever since. He invited us out to his movie, a movie set of the Pelham movie he made, and sat on set in between doing scenes with Jordan all day. And then he and I went out to dinner that evening, and he read the journal. And from there, when the timing was right and we had the right script, he decided he would direct. And he chose Mike. And the first thing I thought is, oh my gosh, Mike and Charles looked alike. And I also knew that Michael was a big and rising star who was very talented. And so it was great to have him involved. And then when it came to Shantae, Denzel and I went over so many names of actresses. And I remember sitting in his living room one day, and he has his computer open. He's looking at actresses. I'm looking at actress names. And I said, what about this one? When? And so forth. And he said, I'll know her when I see her. And he called me one day and he said, open up your computer. And I said, I'm in the supermarket. And he said, well, go home, open your computer. And when I did, I said, Shantae popped up and I said, wow. Well, she looks like me from back then. I mean, obviously, she's a lot younger than I am. She's playing me at a different time in my life. And then we talked on the phone, and she just had this absolutely beautiful spirit. And she mm-hmm. really wanted to get to know us. And she was perfect. There's nobody else for this role. She's my little sister now. We rarely mm-hmm. refer to each other by name. We call each other sis. She and her parents are spending Christmas with us. Jordan calls her Auntie. She's been to my beach house for the weekend. I love her. I've got her back for the rest of her life. I'm her big sister. And I'm very protective of her. We're all going to be saying we knew her when.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's an amazing cast, and they did a beautiful job. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.